Hey guys, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So a very good morning to all of you, and this series of morning tales is to add up to your knowledge of current affairs in order to help you in cracking your examinations like RBI, SEBI, NABARD or any kind of banking examination at the level of PU. So let's begin this video without wasting any time, and the guys who are coming for the first time can subscribe to this channel and hit this bell notification. Also, you can join this Telegram group and the link is in description box below. So this is our first question. Which state has launched Abhiyam mobile application to help women and children traveling in taxis and auto rickshaws to raise an alarm in case of an emergency? So the purpose of this app is quite clear from the question itself, that is to help women and children who are in distress while traveling in auto rickshaw and taxis. Now, which state has launched it? The right answer is option B, Andhra Pradesh. Who is the CM of Andhra Pradesh? It is Jagan Mohan Reddy. So the CM of Andhra Pradesh has launched this Abhiyam app. Now guys, there is an interesting fact about Andhra Pradesh that I am going to tell you. So the fact is that Andhra Pradesh is the first state that has launched a new legislature, which is named as Disha Bill. So this Disha Bill was not formed in 2020, it was in news in 2019. So this Disha Bill was introduced in 2019 by Andhra Pradesh Cabinet, Andhra Pradesh Assembly, and this Disha Bill is the first ever bill at the state level that is solely for women security. So that was the interesting fact about Andhra Pradesh, and that's all for this question. Let's move on to the next question. What is the name of the vision adopted by APEC Economic Leaders Meeting 2020 for guiding its operations for the next two decades? So basically, these are the various cities, and out of these options, there is one option which is the name of this document, vision document that has been adopted by APEC. Now, first of all, you should know this thing, that this APEC Economic Leaders Summit was hosted by Malaysia. Malaysia is the host of APEC Summit in 2020, and it has hosted this Economic Leaders Meeting as well, wherein this Putrajaya Vision 2040 document, that is basically a guiding document, a strategy document kind of a thing, that is going to guide the APEC in their operations for the next two decades. That's why the number is 2040. So that's all for this question. There is nothing much to discuss. Now, you should know this thing, that in 2020, Malaysia is the hosting country, and in 2021, New Zealand will host this APEC Summit 2021 in a virtual format. So we have discussed about the summits of APEC, and now it's time for us to discuss about the static facts related to APEC. First of all, APEC stands for Asia Pacific Economic Cooperation. It was established in 1989, 21 countries are members, headquarters in Singapore. So these are the static facts that you have to remember. 2020 summit of APEC was virtually conducted by Malaysia, and the theme of that summit is optimizing human potential towards future of shared prosperity. So guys, I know that themes are a little longer and they are a little difficult to remember, but you have to remember the themes of important days as well as summits, because they can ask you the themes in examination. So therefore the themes are important and you have to remember it anyway. Now the next fact is 2021 summit of APEC will be held virtually by New Zealand. So that we have discussed already. Now let's move on to the next question. So this is a very simple question of acquisition. In which company have Canara Bank, Axis Bank, Indian Bank and South Indian Bank acquired 6.67% stake each? So All these four banks have acquired 6.67% stake at the same time in a company. That company is a financial technology company. So which company is it? The right answer is IBBIC. So that is the answer of this question, and that's all for this question because it's a simple acquisition question and nothing else is required from you to remember from this news. So just stick to the facts that I have told you here. Now, which company has signed an agreement for the acquisition of 26% stake in Hinduja Renewable 2 Private Limited? So this company has been, 26% stake of this company has been acquired by Biocon Limited. So this company is important. It has been in the news for many reasons, but this company has now signed an agreement to acquire 26% stake in this Hinduja company, which is also an important company. Now my question for you is that you have to tell me the founder and CEO of Biocon Limited. Why is this person important? The reason behind that is the CEO and founder of this Biocon Limited is an important personality and is one of the billionaires of India, is one among the billionaire women of India. So I have told you enough. Now it is a task for you that you have to find out the founder and CEO of Biocon Limited. And now let's move on to the next question. Which state has launched the Maha Awas Yojana, a new rural housing project to build 8.82 lakh rural houses in 100 days period? So this scheme, Maha Awas Yojana, is on the lines of Prime Minister Awas Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana. So under this project, 8.82 lakh houses, rural houses will be built in 100 days. Now which state has launched it? It is Maharashtra. Maha is common. Maharashtra and Maha Awas Yojana. So from here you can remember these things, that this project was launched by Maharashtra, and under this project in 100 days over 8 lakh houses will be built. So that's all for this question. Now your task is to tell me the governor of Maharashtra as well as the CM of Maharashtra. So do tell me in the comment section below. Next question is, who has been elected as the external auditor of Inter-Parliamentary Union for a 3-year term? So, Inter-Parliamentary Union has been discussed by me earlier as well. So, here I will be asking you the questions from IPU. So, that I will be doing later. But for the time being, let's discuss the answer of this question first. So, the answer of this question is CAG India. That is, the person who is the Comptroller Auditor General of India has been appointed as the External Auditor of IPU. Now, do you guys know that who is this person? The answer is Girish Chandra Murmu. So, he is the person who is at present the CAG India, and he has assumed this post very recently. Therefore, high chances that this question might come up in the examination. And this question is very important. This question is also important. Now, from IPU, the questions that you have to answer is, so these are the three questions that you have to answer in relation to IPU. And I have already discussed these three questions in one of the morning day sessions previously. So now I expect you guys to answer the questions in the comment section. Next question is, who has been appointed as the US Secretary of State under Joe Biden's administration? So Joe Biden is the 46th President of United States. Why are we discussing about his cabinet? The reason behind this is that the examinations are right around the corner. There is SBIPO examination and we also have SEBI grade examination. So that is where the current affairs which are there in the month of November, December, January are very, very important. So you should not leave any important or significant fact. And this Secretary of State is an important position in United States. Therefore, it is important for us to know that who is that person. So the person is Antony Blinken. He has been appointed as the new United States Secretary of State. So that's all for this question. In which month is the National Newborn Week 2020 observed? The right answer is November. So in November, this month is observed. And guys, do you know that India in 2014 became the first country to have an action plan to reduce the mortality of newborns? So that is an important fact regarding India. Back then in 2014, India became the first country to have such an action plan to reduce the mortality rate of newborns and stillbirths. So that's all for this question. Now, you should also know the theme of this week. So what is the theme? So this is the theme of this National Newborn Week 2020, Quality, Equity, Dignity for Every Newborn at Health Facility and Everywhere. So again, this is a long theme, but still we can't help it. We have to remember these themes if we want to clear the examination. Now, our next question is, what is the theme of National Pharmacy Week 2020? Okay, so this reminds me that I forgot to tell you that when is this National Newborn Week observed. So in November, during 15 to 21st November 2020, this week is observed. Remember this thing. National Pharmacy Week is observed from 16 to 22 November. And what is the theme? The theme is Pharmacist Frontline Health Professionals. Now, how can you remember it better? From the word frontline. This frontline word is very much in the news because of the COVID pandemic. And therefore, this theme is comparatively easier to remember. So that's all for this question, theme, day and the week. So here ends our session. I hope that you have really liked this session. And if you have, then do share this session and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.